Okay, shall I start with the class? Students, can you all hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Sirisha, Gayatri, Satvik. So I'll start with this. Can you all see the slides?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is a continuation of the communicable diseases part 4. So now today I will discuss about the few other communicable diseases. Very important is trachoma. So it is also called as what? Egyptian ophthalmia. And what is the meaning of the word trachoma over here? So trachoma means what? Rough. So something that appears rough, it is called as trachoma, and it is a Greek word. So can you see the picture over here? So what you can see over here, some roughened area over here. Actually, these are the follicles. So this roughness, can you all hear me, student? Students?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So trachoma means rough appearance. So in the eye, there will be rough appearance. So that's why it is called as trachoma. It basically involves what? Sclera and the conjunctiva. And it is basically caused by what? It is a bacterial infection caused by Chlamydia trachomatis. So it is a gram-negative bacteria, and here different serotypes are there. So in examination, they can ask you which of the following serotypes are linked with the trachoma. So the option should be A, B and C. So these are the three serotypes that are exclusively linked with the causation of the what? Trachoma. And whereas the other serotypes, that is from D to K, so the serotypes of the same Chlamydia only, so again from D to K, they are usually sexually transmitted, and they are rarely involved in the causation of the blindness or vision loss, and they are mainly linked with the genital infections and also with the respiratory infections, and more commonly it infects the infants. If at all there is an eye problem caused by this sexually transmitted Chlamydia, then we call it as inclusion conjunctivitis, especially if it occurs in the infants. So eye for inclusion and eye for infants. And if it occurs in the adults, then it is called as swimming pool conjunctivitis. So remember, students, D to K serotypes are linked with which one, students? It is linked with sexually transmitted Chlamydia trachomatis. Whereas A, B and C, these are the three serotypes which are linked with the causation of the ocular trachomatis. Are you all clear? Roshan?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now there is another type of serotype of the same Chlamydia only, that is L serotype, that is L1, L2 and L3. If at all the question is asked, the L serotype of the Chlamydia causes which type of disease? That is lymphomatous granulosum. So the L itself indicates that it basically involves the genital tract infection. So it is caused by L1, L2 and L3. So our importance and focus will be only on this Chlamydia trachomatis. So it is caused by A, B and C serotypes. It is also called as classical or endemic trachoma. And very important is that, remember this word, it is one of the leading cause of preventable blindness in the world. Because MCQs are asked related to this particular word itself. So which one of the following is the preventable cause of blindness? So the option should be what? Trachoma. Because if we take the proper measure, then we can prevent this trachoma eye infection. And we can also prevent the ultimate dreadful consequence of this trachoma, that is the vision loss or blindness. And how it is transmitted, students, Roshan and others? It is transmitted basically from the eye, nose or the throat secretions. So if the bacteria, it infects a host, then what happens? It will be seen in the secretions of the eye. It can be seen present in the secretions of the nose and even in the throat secretions. So when such an infected child or the individual comes in contact with another human, so they will also get this particular infection. But very important is that the infectivity is of low infectivity. Like even though it infects a person, but the chance of getting infected is low or less. This point is very important. and it can also be spread by the fomites by the use of handkerchiefs. If one fellow is using the handkerchief infected with the trachoma, if somebody uses the same thing, then again the chance of getting the trachoma is very high. Then it can also be spread by the flies, the domestic flies. Can you all see in this picture, students? Sirisha, Akarsh and others. Students?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So, can also be spread by the flies. That is a common house fly, that is Musca domestica. So, it is also one of the source of spread. And very rarely or sometimes occasionally it can be caused by the venereal root. Then it is very common in the children who are between the age of 2 to 5 years. If this option is not given, if the option is given as less than 10 years, then you can mark it as a correct option. And elder women who are in close contact with the children, even they also can get infected with this trachoma. And what are the predisposing factors for the trachoma? It is sunlight, dust, smoke and the kajal or the surma. So our Indian tradition or the practice, it says that the newborn or the children or the small children, they should be, their eyes should be coated or they lined with what? The kajal. But it is an irritant and it may cause the spread of the trachoma. So it is one of the predisposing factor. And what are the other factors? By crowded places or poor sanitation or where there is water scarcity. Why? Because what happens if the hygiene practices are not good and if the water is not adequate amount or water supply is not adequately there in that, then what happens? The person cannot follow the proper hygienic measures. They can't wash their faces properly. So that the chances that the face will be very dirty and it will attract the flies or the the trachoma infection will be more common in the areas of water scarcity. And which part of the world is very commonly affected by this trachoma? It is African area. So whatever the points are there on the slides, no, everything can be asked as an MCQ question for you, whether it may be any type of examination. Now let us see something about this bacteria. Some question can be asked exclusively on this organism itself. It is caused by which one, students? It is caused by which of
organisms?
Saccharomyces. And what is the nature of this organism? This organism or this bacteria cannot live outside the host cell. That means what? It is intracellularly. It definitely has to live within the host cell. So that especially the epithelial cells within the cell, it will be there. So that it can survive and it can metabolize and it can divide. And very important is that now in the cell, it produces an inclusion body. It is called as what? Halberstadter Provaseke body. This word is very important. It is very much classical with this trachoma. So intracytoplasmic, so within the cytoplasm. Inclusion bodies are seen. It is called as what? Students? What is inclusion body over here?
Halberstadter Provaseke body.
Halberstadter body.
So it is one of the pathognomic feature histopathologically for this trachoma. So when you take epithelial cells, you can see this inclusion bodies. Then what exactly happens is clinical presentation for the trachoma. So whenever there is an infection or repeated infection of this trachoma to the eyes, there will be inflammation of the conjunctiva. This inflammation results in what? Scarring of the conjunctiva if no proper treatment is given. So especially below the eyelid, there will be scarring. This scarring results in what? There will be dip or the ditch that is created, that is called as entropion. So this is one of the clinical feature. And this scarring, it results in what? The eyelashes, whatever is there, it will directly rub against the eyeball. So that it causes what? Trichiasis. So this is the next stage followed for this trachoma. Then this trichiasis causes what? It causes irritation, discomfort and pain to the child or the person who is infected. Can you look at the picture over here? The individual is just scratching the eye that is infected and this will finally result in what? Scarring and the blindness. So these are the clinical stages, how it gradually progresses from the inflammation to the blindness. So what all things will happen, students, in the trachoma? So the individual who is infected, there will be inflammation, entropion,
conjunctiva first.
Yeah. Then trichiasis, then ultimately it results in blindness.
blindness.
Then what is this? Herbert's pit. So in examination, this picture can be given and a question can be asked. It is also one of the pathognomic feature or the diagnostic feature of this trachoma. So what are these? When the follicles resolve, so it will leave the areas of depression on the site. So can you see the areas of depression over here?
Yes, sir.
So this depressed or the pit type of areas, they are called as what? Herbert pit. And it is a diagnostic feature of what? Trachoma. So remember this point. Now look at this picture. So WHO has said that clinically we can again categorize into two groups of clinical presentation. One is acute trachoma clinical features, another is chronic stage. In acute or the active, it is also called as what, students? It is also called as active trachoma. So here it is also, just a second. So it is also called as infective trachoma. So what can be seen over here? It is a very early stage. The child will present with the discharge from the eye, pain and irritation. Can you look at over here? The child is presenting with the discharge, pain and irritation. And there will be at least 5 follicles seen on the upper tarsal conjunctiva. This is very important. Can you see over here in this picture? The follicles will be, how many follicles will be there? More than 5 follicles. This is one of the very important feature. So this is the active trachoma. Once this is further continued or no treatment is available, it will progress leading to chronic trachoma or the chronic stage. So it is also called as what? Scarring trachoma. So it is usually seen in the repeated infection or untreated trachoma. There will be corneal opacities. Can you see the picture over here? There will be corneal opacities and it will ultimately result in blindness. Now, why it is important for us? Students, Sirisha and others, why it is important for us? Because from the public health point of view, India has declared that we are free from the infectious trachoma. So the first part, that is active or the infectious trachoma, we are totally free from this infectious trachoma and it has been declared in the year 2017. 20. So what was the thing is that it was declared by the health minister of then, by Sri Jagat Prakash Nadda. So what he has said that India is totally free from infectious trachoma because the trachoma prevalence was found to be only 0.7% in India, which is much less than that of the WHO estimation. So WHO said that at least it should be less than 5% in the age group less than 10 years. So we are already much lesser than that particular given percentage. So India has declared that trachoma is no more a public health problem in India. So it is one of the achievement. And this point is very important. Just look at here. World Health Organization grading for trachoma. Again, some MCQs can be asked in this. So WHO has said that totally 5 gradings can be given for this trachoma. So according to WHO, how many are there? 5 gradings are there. So what are these 5 gradings? So one is TF, that is trachomatous inflammation follicular. So here you can see some follicles over here on the upper tarsal conjunctiva. So at least it says that at least there should be 5 or more follicles should be present on the upper tarsal conjunctiva. Then we can say that it is TF, that is trachomatous follicular. Next is trachomatous inflammation, that is TI. So this is the second grading. So TI, that means what? There will be pronounced inflammatory thickening of the upper tarsal conjunctiva. So at least like more than half of the upper tarsal conjunctiva will be severely inflamed. Then we call it as what? TI. Then further progression, it will lead to TS, that is trachoma scarring. Can you see the scarring over here? In the upper tarsal conjunctiva, all the scar formation has taken place. Then it is grade T. Then what about TT? That is trachomatous trichiasis. So what is trachomatous trichiasis? So what will be there here? The eyelash, it will rub on the eyeball. Because so can you see the lactose, picture?
Lactose leads to glucose and galactose. And galactose cannot be digested here. So eliminate milk and milk products from diet.
Students, can you just switch off your microphone?
Even breastfeeding is contraindicated in confirmed cases.
Yeah.
So that is about galactose.
Can you kindly switch off the microphone because some disturbance is being caused here? Yeah, thank you. Now, in the TFT, that is a grade 4, that is trachomatous trichiasis. So, what will be there? So, the eyelash, it will rub over the eyeball.
And you know what happens? The child cannot digest
what? Student, can you just switch off the microphone?
So, what happens? The child takes sucrose, glucose, fructose, and fructose cannot be digested. So, the child will have symptoms on taking sweet food.
Student.
So, you know, the child will learn and develop an aversion to sweet food.
Ma'am, Roshan's microphone.
Child has aversion to sweet food. He does not want to eat sweet.
Okay. Roshan.
And you know, if you test for reducing substance in urine, it will be positive.
Roshan, can you switch off the microphone, Roshan?
In urine, positive. So, the treatment will be again eliminate fructose from diet. Okay. Moving.
Yeah. Now in the grade 5, that is corneal opacity, this is the terminal grade. So where the person, you can see the opacity over the cornea indicating that the person has reached the stage of blindness. Now what is the diagnosis of trachoma? So we need to do the eye examination. We can take the eye swab to identify the bacteria. And what is the treatment over here? Very important. Jayashree and others, what is the treatment over here? We can give the azithromycin 20 milligrams per kg oral strat. Yes. And eye surgery can be done to correct the eyelid deformity. Now what is SAFE? SAFE, students, Sirisha and others. So it is nothing but, short form, like it can be elaborated as S stands for surgery, S is for surgery. And A is for use of antibiotics, F is for facial cleanliness, and E is for environmental changes. Now, World Health Organization in the year 1993, it said that to prevent the trachoma from the world, so this particular strategy can be followed. So what is this strategy? It says that we need to do the surgery of the eyelid, if at all, if required. Then antibiotics, especially azithromycin or Zithromax, nothing but the azithromycin. So it should be used to treat the condition of trachoma. And we need to clean the face in order to maintain the facial hygiene and the body hygiene. And there should be some environmental changes. So that what happens, because of this, good water supply and sanitation has to be maintained, so that individual hygiene and the community hygiene should be maintained to prevent the spread of trachoma. So this particular SAFE guidelines was given by whom, students? It was given by World Health Organization. Very important MCQ question. Now, what is a mass treatment or the blanket treatment for the trachoma? So, like, it is like individually we can ask the patient to use what? We can ask the patient to use azithromycin. If not, if the entire community, more than 10% of the people in that particular geographic area are affected with the trachoma, then we can go ahead with the use of what? Mass or the blanket chemo prophylaxis. So when it is indicated when more than 10% of the children are affected with the trachoma. Students, can you all hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So when is this mass prophylaxis is indicated? It is indicated when more than 10% of the children are affected. So what do we do over here? If more than 10% of the children are showing trachoma, then give 1% tetracycline ointment to all the children. This is one point. So how we should advise them? To use it twice daily, for 5 days each month. Every month, twice daily for five days for 6 consecutive months. So 6 months continuously in a week, 5 days, it should be used 1% tetracycline ointment. Otherwise, what is the alternate way to advise them? At least use once daily 1% tetracycline ointment for 10 days for continuous 6 months. If tetracycline is not available, then erythromycin can be an alternate antibiotic. Yes. And if the district, it shows the prevalence is less than 10%, that is between 5 to 10%, then we can go for targeted treatment, that is, no need to give each and every person in that community for this erythromycin or azithromycin. we can just give only the people who are infected and their family members called as targeted chemoprophylaxis with the azithromycin. And if at all the district shows the prevalence of trachoma less than 5% in children who are less than 10 years old, then mass treatment of azithromycin is not required. Yes? Then what is GET? Global elimination of trachoma. So global elimination of trachoma, for the it is like a goal has been set up. By 2020, we need to just eliminate this trachoma. It was again started by the WHO only. So it says that every country should strictly follow the safe strategy in order to eliminate this trachoma globally. And for this, the WHO will provide the monitoring and resource mobilization, and further assistance will be provided by the WHO to the needed countries. What is the next aim for trachoma in India? So in India, to eliminate the trachoma, what is the thing? Our India has now targeted for the elimination of the trachomatous trichiasis, that is TT, from the country. Already we have eliminated which one? Students, TI, that is acute trachomatis. So this particular thing, we have already eliminated it. And it has been declared in the year, which year, students? And it has been declared in the year 2017. Yes? Can you all hear me, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now let us see some of the MCQs related to trachoma.
Screening, ma'am.
Yeah. So the first question is safe. Safe strategy includes all except. So now the question is asked related to except. Annarao, can you answer? Students, Jayashree and others, what does the safe strategy stands for? Roshan? Roshan?
Screening, ma'am.
It is screening. Very good. So S stands for what?
Surgery.
Surgery, antibiotics, facial cleanliness, and environmental change, ma'am.
Yeah. Safe. Antibiotic, facial washing, and environmental improvement. Now the first option is wrong. So screening is the answer to be opted over here. Next, true about trachoma is. So what is the statement true? The question is asked like this. Now the disease is of high infectivity. Now do you think this word is correct or wrong? False. In the beginning itself, we have learned that it is of low infectivity.
No,
this is not true. Then prevalence of severe and moderate trachoma less than 10%. It is not 1%. Okay, fine. So prevalence of severe and moderate trachoma less than 1% in children of less than 10 years age is an indication for mass treatment. So when do we go for mass treatment, students? In a community, it should be greater than 10%. Now this second one is also not true. Then irritants like kajal or surma also predispose to trachoma. This is correct,
true.
Actually. And it is unavoidable cause of blindness in India. Do you think it is unavoidable?
No, ma'am.
No. It is one of the preventable cause of blindness in the world itself. So it is a preventable. Now you people tell me which is the correct statement about the trachoma.
Third one.
Irritants like kajal or surma can predispose to trachoma. So this is the answer. Next. For the field diagnosis of trachoma, the WHO recommends that follicular and intense trachoma inflammation should be assessed in. Now, we already know that this trachoma is basically an infection of the children who are less than 10 years of age. So, our focus, we need to examine them only. So, which should be the answer?
0 to 10.
Yeah, it should be 0 to 10 years. So, we need to basically focus for examining the children who are less than 10 years. So, the answer is 3. Next, in the grading of trachoma, so grading of trachoma was given by whom? World Health Organization. How many grades are there? 5 grades are there. Now in the grading of trachoma, trachomatous inflammation follicular, that is TF, is defined as a presence of. So when you say it is a TF,
first option, 5 or more follicles in
there. So the upper or more. Conjunctiva, how many follicles should be there? It should be more than 5, at least 5 or more than 5 follicles should be present. Then only we can say that it is TF, that is trachoma follicularis. So what is the answer over here? Third one, 5 or more follicles in the upper tarsal conjunctiva. If you look at the other options,
yes,
they are saying lower tarsal conjunctiva, lower tarsal conjunctiva, both 1 and 2 option, which is nowhere linked to its grading. And the fourth, the last option, it says that 3 or more follicles, it is also not correct. So answer is 3. Next, mass treatment of trachoma is undertaken when the prevalence is more than. So when do we go ahead with the mass?
10%.
More than 10%. This number should be there in your mind. So if the number is more than 10%, then we can go ahead with which one? Mass prophylaxis. Next, single drug treatment recommended for the trachoma control in India. So trachoma means what? Very good. What is the drug of choice? Azithromycin. Don't look here and there for any other option. Trachoma, azithromycin. So which option is right over here, students? Sirisha, Jayashree, Anna Rao, others?
Second one, ma'am.
Second one. So it is azithromycin. Next. Azithromycin mass treatment is given in the community when the prevalence of trachoma is more than. So when it is indicated, again mass treatment.
10%.
It is more than 10%.
Same.
So this is all the NCQ questions related to trachoma. We will go to the second or the next communicable disease, that is scabies. So it is a dermatological condition which is caused by which one, students? Sarcoptis scabies, especially the female one. And what is this? It is a mite. It is a mite. So remember this, MCQs are asked related to this particular thing. Scabies is caused by flea, fly, or whatever it is, mosquito or mite. So what is the option over here? Scabies mite. Is caused by mite. Yeah. Remember this. And very important is that this particular scabies causing organism, that is a mite, wherever it bites, you know. So from the area of bite, look at the picture here. So this bite, it will get into the below the skin, that is, it lives inside the epidermis. It will create a burrow. It will create a what? Burrow. So this female will create a burrow, and then meanwhile, while living in this burrow, it will lay its eggs. It will lay the eggs. So now what is the thing over here? Burrow is the very important clinical feature of this
characteristic
scabies. Characteristic feature. Then how it is transmitted? It is transmitted from person to person. And contact. The areas which are crowded places, unhygienic places, especially the schools, all these are the risk factors for the occurrence of this scabies. Now look at the picture here. It shows the life cycle of this mite. So from the skin, it will just go below the epidermis. So it will, the female will go and it will create a burrow, and during its path, it will lay all these eggs. Then what will happen? This eggs will hatch. It will form the larva. And after 3 to 4 days, this larva will be changed to nymph. And after another 4 to 7 days, this nymph will be converted to adult female. And again, it will go out of the same burrow to the out of the skin, and it will infect the other part of the skin. So like this, it will continue its life cycle. Now, what are the clinical features of this scabies? Very important is intense pruritus, that is itching. Especially the patient says that in the night, my sleep is disturbed. So itching, and more severe during the night time. And you can also see the erythematous papules can be seen. And very important is burrow. So can you see the burrow over here? Students, look at the picture over here. Can you all see here? Sirisha and others. Roshan, Akarsh.
Yes, ma'am.
So these are the burrows. So which are like 1 to 10 mm long burrows. So this site, wherever it bites, no, so from that bite area, it will create a burrow. So just below this burrow, no, this fellow mite will be living over there. So when we do the skin scraping, definitely we can catch this culprit. So burrow are nothing but the tunnels. So which is a pathognomic for scabies. So in a MCQ, if at all some clinical case presentation, itching and presence of burrow means, then just think that it is a scabies. Then very important is that on at the areas of the finger webs. So here also you can see some rashes, and also burrows can be seen over here at the site of the finger webs. And rashes can also be seen in the axillary region and also in the belt line. So it is a belt line, and also rashes can be seen in the buttock area and even in the genital area. So these are all the clinical, classic clinical presentations of this scabies. So how do we diagnose this? Roshan and others, Anna Rao, Jayashree, how do we diagnose it? So very important is that we need to take the skin scraping. We need to take the skin scraping. What we do over here, so wherever this burrow is there or the skin lesion is there, put the mineral oil. What do? We put the mineral oil. Then we take the scalpel, then we scrape the skin, and we put the skin scraping on the slide. Then we look at in the microscope for the presence of this mite or the organism. Yes, this is very important. It is called as skin scraping. Skin scraping using what, students?
Mineral oil.
Mineral oil. Now, what is the treatment for this? Very, very important. MCQ are asked drug related to this. Yeah, permethrin. So this is the most recommended cream or the that is topically used for the treatment of this scabies. Then very important is that we need to treat the contacts also. And very important is no need for mass prophylaxis. Because in trachoma, we have seen that for the entire community residing in that trachoma affected area, we can go ahead with giving the mass prophylaxis, even for the children or the adults who are not infected. But here for scabies, no need of mass prophylaxis because no benefits were found. And best thing is that we need to treat the contacts over there. And we need to wash the clothes, beddings in the boiling hot water. Now let us see some MCQs related to the scabies. Now students, you mite. People only answer what type mite. Of organism causes scabies.
Mite.
It is mite. What is the name of this mite?
Sarcoptis scabies.
Yeah, Sarcoptis scabies. So mosquito fly, they are not related to this scabies. So the answer is mite. Which of the following clinical finding is pathognomic of scabies? So which is pathognomic? Burrows, diffuse involvement, erythematous papule, or sparing groin. So answer is which one, students? It is burrows. So we already read that burrows is a pathognomic feature of scabies. Now, do you think groin will be spared over here? No. This area
will be infected.
Commonly affected. Now, read the question over here. A 5-year-old boy presents with rash for how many weeks? 2 weeks. The itch has disturbed his sleep. Now, the boy is complaining of what, students? It's itch which has disturbed his sleep. So that means what? It is a severe itch or the pruritus. And multiple erythematous papules are seen on the trunk and groin area. And very important is burrows are present on the second and third web spaces on the right hand. So what is there? On the right hand, what is there? In the web spaces, what is present? The burrows are seen. So here, what are present in the web spaces? Burrows. What is the in-office procedure which best confirms the diagnosis? Now, what you can do to confirm the diagnosis? Students, now you can answer. Now, already you got an idea that some clue is that?
Skin scraping.
Skin scraping. Everyone, do you agree with this? Anna Rao and others, Gayatri, Roshan and others?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. It is skin scraping because this KOH preparation, potassium hydroxide, it is basically used to detect what? Fungal infection of the
infection.
Skin. And nail clipping, it is again used to check for the fungal infection of the nail. Then skin scraping, it is exclusively done using mineral oil for confirming the diagnosis of what? Scabies. So remember, scabies and skin scraping. Yes, yes. None of the above is not the option over here. Our answer is what? Skin scraping. So this completes about what? Scabies. Any doubts over here, students?
No, ma'am.
So we'll go to the next communicable disease, that is rickettsial disease. Very important. So rickettsial disease, it is caused by, it is a group of infection. It is a group of diseases, group of diseases or the infection caused by rickettsial organism. It is what, bacteria or virus? What is this rickettsia? Students, rickettsia is a bacteria because earlier it was considered to be virus.
Bacteria.
But later it has been said that no, they show the properties of the bacteria. Now it is put under the category of what? Bacteria. It is a gram negative. It is a gram negative coccobacilli. And they are very small in size. And they are non-motile. And they are obligate intracellular. That means what? They are present within the cell. They can't survive outside the host cell. And they divide by what type of method? They divide by binary fission. So these are the points which you need to remember. And how... Now, where does this rickettsial organism they reside? They reside in the fleas, lice, ticks and mites. So these are the what? These are the vectors or the agents that carry this rickettsial organism. That is tick, flea, lice and the mites. Not mosquito. And most are zoonosis except for Q fever. So Q fever is caused by which one, students?
Limic typhus.
Yeah. Yes, Roshan.
Coxsella.
Yeah, Q fever, no, it is caused by Coxsella, but very important is that it is not transmitted by any of this arthropods, not fleas, lice or ticks or mites. It is basically due to the inhalation of the dust or drinking the contaminated milk or the milk products or by the aerosols. So these are the basic routes for the transmission of the Q fever. And what are the antigens that are exclusive for this rickettsial bacteria? So very important is that group specific antigen, species specific antigen. So we are not much concerned with these two, one or two. The very important for us is which one? That is third one, that is alkali stable polysaccharide antigen. Why this is very important? Because this particular antigen is even using this wheel flex reaction can be demonstrated. I'll explain you this thing in the further slides. So this rickettsial organism, it has been categorized into how many genera? Four genera are there. So what are these four genera? Rickettsia genera, Orientia genera, Coxsella and Ehrlichia. Now this first genera, it causes which one? Two categories of diseases. One is typhus, another is spotted fever. And the second genera, it causes which one? Scrub fever. And third genera, that is Coxsella, it causes which one? Q fever. And the fourth genera, not very much important for us. So it causes the febrile illness and ehrlichiosis. And very important is that once a tick, mite or flea, whatever it bites, to show the clinical features, it nearly requires 1 to 2 weeks. And it is most common in the travelers. Very important. And so, some other classic feature is that we already know that these rickettsial organisms, they are present exclusively in the host cells. Now in the cell, it can be present within the cytoplasm or it can be present within the nucleus. If you see the typhus causing organism, it is present in the cytoplasm. Any spotted fever causing organism, it is present in the, where it is present, student? It is present in the nucleus. whereas coxiella and ehrlichia, it is present in the cytoplasmic vacuoles. Now this table is very important. Just remember this. There is no other option. You have to just remember this. So we already know that typhus group, it is a group of disease caused by the rickettsial organism. Typhus group may again three types of diseases are there. One is epidemic typhus, another is murine typhus. It is also called as what, students? Endemic typhus. Another one is scrub typhus. Now the epidemic typhus is caused by which one, students? Rickettsia provaziaki. So it is caused by which one? Rickettsia provaziaki. And what is the vector for this? It is basically the body louse. And what is the reservoir? Human. Next is murine. Murine or the endemic typhus. It is caused by which one? It is caused by R. typhi. And it is basically spread by which vector? It is spread by flea. So remember, murine, M. It is nothing but indicating that rat. So it is nothing but infected rat. So this infected rat, when it is like harboring this flea will suck the blood of the rat. And from this, it will, this flea will come out and it will bite the human. So like this, it will spread from infected rat to the human. So then we call it as what? Murine typhus. Next is scrub typhus. It is caused by which one, students? It is caused by Rickettsia suzugomashi. So what is the vector for this? It is mite. So again, mite, again it is what? Scrub typhus. It is, the vector is mite, and this mite infects, it gets infected by the rodents. Next, spotted fever. Again, spotted fever, many varieties are there. So very few important things for us is Indian tick typhus. Indian ITT, that is Indian tick typhus. It is caused by Rickettsia coenoeri. Very important. And what is the agent for the, or the vector for this? It is tick. Next is Rocky Mountain spotted fever. So Rocky Mountain spotted fever, remember, it is caused by what? R triple R, that is Rickettsia rickettsiae. So Rocky Mountain tick spotted fever, it is caused by R, that is Rickettsia rickettsiae. And its vector is which one, students? Tick. And rickettsial pox. Rickettsial pox, it is caused by which one? Rickettsia acari. It is caused by which one, students? Acari. Because related to this table itself, multiple questions has been asked in various examination. And it is spread by which one? Mite. And others like Q fever, it is caused by which one, students? Coxiella burnetii. So again, here there is no vector over here, because I already told you that it is spread by which one? Dust. Students, can you all hear me? It is spread by dust, aerosols. Then it is also spread by milk. Another thing is the trench fever. What is the other name for trench fever, students? It is also called as Roshan. What is the other name for trench fever? It is also called as 5-day fever. It is caused by which one? R. quintana. And what is the vector for this? Again, it is the body louse. And what is the reservoir for this? It is the humans. Now, basically, if you see the pathogenesis of this rickettsia, so basically this organism, it has got affinity towards what? The vascular tissue. So it infects what? Which one? Vascular tissue. So in the vascular tissue, what does it will do? It will damage the endothelial cells, and this ultimately results in what? It causes a thrombosis of the vessels, and then the vessel will rupture and it will lead to the necrosis of the vessels. So ultimately it causes what? Vasculitis. It causes what? Vasculitis. So this is one of the classic or pathognomic feature of all of the rickettsial diseases. Now little bit, if we look into each of the types of rickettsial disease, so typhus fever. So typhus fever means what? What is the meaning of the word typhus? It is nothing but the mental confusion. So in the during the Hippocrates days, so people who were having this mental confusion, and that particular disease has been termed as typhus fever. So again, this typhus fever is of how many types? Three types are present. Typhus fever is of how many types? Three types. One is epidemic or classical typhus. Another is Brill-Zinsser typhus. Another is endemic or murine typhus. Roshan. Others. Sirisha.
Yes, ma'am.
Sathvik. Can you all hear me?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So the typhus, it is of how many types? Three types are there. Epidemic, Brill-Zinsser, another is endemic or the murine typhus. Now, epidemic typhus or the classical typhus, it is caused by which one? Human body louse. So this is the vector for this particular epidemic typhus. What is the incubation period? It is 5 to 21 days. And what is the case fatality rate? It is only 20 to 30% if not treated. And it is very severe form of the typhus fever. And very important is that there will be fever, headache, myalgia, all these general features, and there will be clouding or the of the consciousness will be there. And rashes, it will appear after the having the or appearance of the fever and headache, then rashes will be seen. And these rashes are seen everywhere in the body, especially in the trunk region, the rashes are seen and it will spread to the periphery. But the rashes are absent in the palms and soles. So it is rashes are absent in the palms and the soles. And it is caused by which one, students? It is caused by Rickettsia prowazekii. Next, once this epidemic typhus, if it is not treated or if it is already treated and subsided, then what happens when the host immunity is lowered? Host immunity is lowered, then what will happen? It will show the recurrence. So then it is called as Brill-Zinsser typhus, and it is also caused by the same organism, Rickettsia prowazekii, and the vector is same thing, louse, and it is nothing but a recurrence form of the epidemic typhus, and it infects the persons to other person very quickly, and it may lead to what? Outbreaks. And fatality is low and clinical features are milder as compared to that of the earlier or the epidemic typhus. Are you all clear, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Next, endemic typhus. So endemic typhus, it is also called as what? Murine typhus. That means what? Murine means what? Rat. It is caused by which one? Infected rat. And that infected rat, if it harbors the flea, and that flea sucks the blood of the infected rat, and that flea, if it bites a human, then we will get this endemic typhus. And man is the accidental host because it spreads from rat to typhus, and again the cycle will continue. But if this flea, if it happens to bite the man, so man is called as what? Accidental host. Whenever the man is accidental host, then what happens? There won't be any man-to-man transmission. There won't be any man-to-man transmission. And what are the reservoir? The reservoir is rat and the cat. These are the reservoir for this endemic typhus. What is the vector for this? So the vector is rat flea. So remember this, rat flea is the vector for this endemic typhus. It is also called as what? Xenophila chiopis. So remember this scientific name for this rat flea, because questions are asked on this. It is caused by which one, students? Xenophila chiopis. Then it is endemic in which areas of the world? Can you all see the slide, students? Student?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, it is endemic,
yes, ma'am,
in Mexico. It is also called as Rickettsia musseri. What is the other name for endemic typhus? It is also called as Rickettsia musseri. And clinical features are very mild. Then what happens? The bite of a rat flea. So when the rat flea, if it bites the host, then the person will get this endemic typhus. Then the rashes occur anywhere and everywhere on the body. But very important is initially that will occur on the trunk region and it will spread to the other areas of the body. Along with the rash, there will be high-grade fever. Then there will be myalgia. then there will be headache. So these are all the different other clinical features of this endemic typhus. So I'll stop it here only. So tomorrow I'll continue with the rest of the rickettsial disease. Then I will continue with the other types of communicable diseases. So same 8 o'clock I will continue. Yes, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
So all of you just go through these points, whichever we have learned today, that is trachoma. Then we have discussed about the scabies and part of the rickettsial disease. And tomorrow at same 8 o'clock, we'll continue with the further rickettsial disease and other communicable diseases. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.